Hi, welcome to Lighthouse Storytime. Today we're going to be reading The Lighthouse Keeper's Lunch. Thanks for joining us and enjoy the story. Once there was a lighthouse keeper called Mr. Grinling. At night, he lived in a small white cottage perched high on the cliffs. In the daytime, he rowed out to his lighthouse on the rocks to clean and polish the light. Mr. Grinling was a most industrious lighthouse keeper. Come rain or shine, he tended his light. Sometimes, at night, Mr. Grinling lay sleeping in his warm bed. The ships would toot and tell him that the night light was shining brightly and clearly out to sea. Each morning, while Mr. Grinling polished the light, Mrs. Grinling worked in the kitchen of the little white cottage on the cliffs, concocting a delicious lunch for him. Once she had prepared the lunch, she packed it into a special basket, clipped it onto a wire, and ran it from the little white cottage to the lighthouse on the rocks. But one Monday, something terrible happened. Mrs. Grinling had prepared a particularly appetizing lunch. She had made a mixed seafood salad, a lighthouse sandwich, cold chicken, sausage and crisps, peach surprise, iced sea biscuits, drinks, and assorted fruits. She put the lunch in the basket, as usual, and sent it down the wire. But the lunch did not arrive. It was spotted by 3 scavenging seagulls who set it upon it and devoured it with great gusto. "Clear off, you varmints," shouted Mr. Grinling, but the seagulls took not the slightest notice. That evening, Mr. and Mrs. Grinling decided on a plan to baffle the seagulls. "Tomorrow I shall tie a napkin to the basket," said Mrs. Grinling. "Of course, my dear," agreed Mr. Grinling. "It sounds like a plan." On Tuesday evening, Mr. and Mrs. Grinling racked their brains for another plan. The basket tied with a cloth didn't work. "What shall we do?" "Our cat does not appear to like seagulls," said Mrs. Grinling. "No, my dear, Hamish is an accomplished seagull chaser." "Of course," explained Mrs. Grinling. "Tomorrow, Hamish can guard the lunch." "A most ingenious plan," agreed Mr. Grinling. Hamish did not think that this plan was ingenious at all. He spat and hissed as Mrs. Grinling secured him in the basket. "There, there, Hamish," said Mrs. Grinling consolingly. "I'll have a tasty piece of herring waiting for you when you arrive home." Sadly, flying did not agree with Hamish. His fur stood on end when the basket swayed. His whiskers drooped when he peered down at the wet blue sea. And he felt much too sick even to notice the seagulls, let alone scare them away from the lunch. "Lack-a-day, lack-a-day," said Mr. Grinling sadly. "Meow, meow," agreed Hamish pitifully. On Wednesday evening, Mr. and Mrs. Grinling racked their brains again for a new plan. "What shall we do?" said Mr. Grinling. Mrs. Grinling looked thoughtful. "I have it, just the mixture for the hungry seagulls." "Indeed, my dear," said Mr. Grinling. "What do you have in mind?" "Wait and see," said Mrs. Grinling. "Just wait and see." "Mustard sandwiches," chuckled Mr. Grinling. "A truly superb plan, my dear. Truly superb." On Thursday morning, Mrs. Grinling carefully packed the mustard sandwiches and sent them off down the wire to the expectant seagulls. "Yuck! Ugh!" uttered the seagulls. On Friday, Mrs. Grinling repeated the mustard mixture. "All right, boys, let's go have lunch somewhere else. It's all the same as yesterday's lunch," announced the seagulls. So on Saturday, up in the little white cottage on the cliffs, a jubilant Mrs. Grinling put away the mustard pot before she prepared a scrumptious lunch for Mr. Grinling. While he waited for his lunch down in the lighthouse on the rocks, Mr. Grinling sang snatches of an old sea shanty as he surveyed the coastline through his telescope. And this is what he saw. "No mustard in this lot," uttered a seagull. "We'll fly back here for lunch tomorrow, boys. And this is a delicious chocolate eclair," they said behind the fisherman. "Oh, well, such is life," mused Mr. Grinling as he sat down to enjoy a leisurely lunch in the warm sunshine.